feel like, yeah, all day like, yeah, all night like, one whole squad like, yeah, in the field like, yeah, all day like, yeah, all night like, yeah, whole squad like, yeah, in the field like, yeah, all day like, yeah, all night like, yeah.
You don't want problems, you don't want smoke, no. You don't want problems. Yeah, you don't want problems, you don't want smoke.
All right, thanks, Coach. EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. Just as we were ready for air, it was the Colts emerging from the locker room to great fanfare here in Indy. They're ready to go as the Colts get set to match up with the Atlanta Falcons. It's the first weekend of autumn, and the NFL is in full swing as off we go on EA Sports. This is taken at his four. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Play fake to Freeman. It's Ryan. It got his man complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A very solid gain of 27. Now from Colts territory, here's a first and 10 at the 49-yard line. From the gun, it's Ryan. And he will find Ridley on the left side. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. The Falcon passing game looking good on this drive as they get the first down. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. A carry for Devontae Freeman, who missed most of last season. And he tried to bounce it outside, but they'll stop him behind the line. That sends him 2 yards in the wrong direction and leads to second down.
Second and 12 at the Colts' 39-yard line.
Ready, Blue Lady, by 25.
Now a fake on the give here as they try to run pass option. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. The tally there, minus 2 yards, brings up third down. A couple of plays sent him the wrong way, and now they face a third and 14. Out of the gun, it's Ryan. And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. So instead of fourth down, first down.
Well, so much for winning the down you put a lot of emphasis on, because third down is key for offense and defense. Instead, you're going to stay on the field and start a new set of downs.
Our game not even 2 minutes old, but a quick red zone opportunity. First and 10 right at the 20. From the shotgun, Ryan looking for Jones, and it's intercepted. Read it well, and it's picked. And they get the football, but not much on the return here as he stopped at the 7-yard line. They were Ball Hawks last week. They had a trio of interceptions on defense in the first drive. They pick up right where they left off.
They're creating quite a reputation for themselves, aren't they? And sometimes what happens is, when they know that the defense can take the ball away, as they saw the previous week, now you try too hard to not let them take it away, and you force yourself into errors. They've intimidated them, in a sense, and gotten the ball from them.
Officials so cognizant of that call nowadays, but that would look pretty easy.
Yeah, you're right. They took out of their hands having to wonder whether it's a 5-yard or a 15-yard inadvertent or not. Now, it's a lot easier. You see it, you call it.
Now it's first and 10. A big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. Now Love. Oh, that was dangerous. Threw it into coverage, almost picked, but instead they'll keep it on second down. Now keep in mind, they did have 3 interceptions last week. Couldn't quite come up with a first quarter pick that time.
But they had to like what they saw in terms of reacting when the ball is thrown. We had an expression when I played, it was called break on it. Every time the quarterback puts the ball in the air, break on the football. Go make a play and accumulate those interceptions.
Former defensive back, you remember those 3 interception games. They can be contagious, give you a little momentum.
They really can, and it doesn't matter whether it's one person or if you spread them across your entire defense, everybody wants a piece of that pie.
Now a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete.
Well, they went for the big play there, but that drop could really hurt their momentum.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has them staring at a 3rd and 10.
Hey, wahoo!
Watch the run. Good shot, baby. That's a baby shot.
Check 50.
Love. Now he'll let it go deep, right side. Oh, wide open, complete. Eric Ebron, his 4th touchdown on the year. And they are able to strike first here on their opening drive. Vinatieri able to tack on the PAT. And that'll make this a 6-point game. So that one will be accepted. After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get them down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part 2, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
On 2nd and 9, Ryan looking. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. That one good for 37 yards.
I know we love our jobs, and pretty much any play we see, we're pretty, you know, excited about. The big plays, let's face it, that's what we absolutely live for. How about that one?
That was great. And what our camera missed was the fist pump from the sideline after that catch. They're fired out. That's a big game. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Add this game to the last one, and they move the ball over 50 yards in 2 plays.
59, ready, we're ready. 54, south, right. Hey, team six.
From the red zone now, here's Ryan on 1st down. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 19. And he's going to take this one back to the 37-yard line.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
Good starting field position for them here as they come up 1st and 10.
Pilot, 64, weak.
45 the mic. Come on.
After the interception, it's Long. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. An excellent way to start the drive there, 18 yards.
And
right after the turnover to come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four. Charles, they won last week despite him not running the ball well. They told us need to get him going. Runs like that help.
And they talked to us about leaning on him because, as you noted, last week they didn't have to. Still won the ball game. They leaned on other people to give him the yardage that they needed. But they really want him to be that guy, and that's what they're doing early in this game.
And a double coverage, and it's intercepted. Ricardo Allen with a pick. And he will take this across midfield and down to the 48-yard line. Charles, I don't know what's going on in that defensive team meeting room, but they better keep it rolling. Three picks last week, two here now in the first quarter.
Everyone talks about creating turnovers and getting takeaways, but until it gets put into action, it's just talk. And right now, it's an act.
That's caught inside the 20. Give him 30 yards there.
Press coverage on the outside, and for defenders, that's the ultimate risk reward. If you take the risk, can you reward yourself by keeping him on the line of scrimmage? But no, not on that one. Got the step on him. Now just a matter of laying the ball out there for him to go get it.
And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Now Ryan. And that'll be hauled in by the tight end. It's Hooper for the Falcon touchdown. Austin Hooper. His third touchdown now on the year. As his guys are on the board here in this first quarter. Extra point up and good by Tavecchio. And we are tied at seven. So all even at seven now as they kick it away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. A tale of two extremes already in this game. A touchdown pass on their opening drive, followed by an interception last time out.
Now, sounds like things balance out, right? What's that mythological thing that we do? If you have a candy bar, have a diet soda with it, it balances it out. And we know that's not really true, right? Because the interception, that sting lingers a little bit longer. Got to come out now and put together some nice plays.
On second and 12, Luck. Throw left side is complete to Rodgers. A gain there of 21 yards. Luck now already over 100 yards passing in just this first quarter. It's first and 10. A shotgun snap for Luck. Ebron with it over the middle. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays.
That was a route run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and flip the down marker back to one.
Hey, Delta.
Now a first down throw, Lock. He's going to air one out into a double team, and it's intercepted. Ricardo Allen with a pick, and a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. This defense had three interceptions last week. They're on pace for more than that here, two in the first half.
Do not adjust your set. This is not instant replay.
And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Quincy Wilson with the INT, and he will bring it back, and interception return for a Colts TD. So that's now three first-half interceptions, and that last one even costlier as it's returned for 6 points. So as a quarterback, how do you regain your focus?
Well, QB 101 says you never show them that you're sweating. Still act like you're the guy, that you've thrown six touchdown passes, not three interceptions. But he's human. He's got to face up to his teammates. He's got to own up to that, see if he can brace up, and also not look over his shoulder and see his backup starting to warm up. It's going to be a tough one for him.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. The drive will start with a carry by Devontae Freeman. And he still has yet to get on track in this first half as they're going to stop him behind the line. Another example right there how this defense really is winning the entire game at the point of attack.
Yeah, right there at the line of scrimmage, because they are dominating it. It allows their interior guys to get upfield and spill into the backfield. So how are you going to combat that? You know, because they bring in your tight end, keep him in, your running backs, they have to step forward. Bottom line, your offensive line has to block them first to give yourself a chance.
Now a nice throw here, right side. He hauls it in. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. A gain there of 21 yards. Ryan now 8 of 11 in this first half. He's got it first and 10. Now it's Ryan. And the possession is theirs at their own 43-yard line. We haven't even escaped the first half, and he's already thrown four picks.
And Brandon, back in the good old days, probably back before you were born, if your starter threw four in the first half, he might throw eight or more for the game because they weren't going to pull him out. But nowadays, the patience level isn't quite there. He's going to have to make some real adjustments, or the backup may see some time.
The catch and run going to wind up netting him 33 yards. So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. Out of the gun, Luck. And that going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
Even without a ton of pressure in his face, it just shows how difficult it is to pick apart his own defense. Those guys are sitting back, and they're not playing receivers as much as they're playing the eyes of the quarterback when he delivers the ball.
And the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. What that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
Over the middle, complete. That's Mack. And he'll get this to the 23, but that'll be well short of what he needed.
That's certainly playing down in distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
And Vinatieri's kick is good. Vinatieri, the NFL's oldest active player, also the league's all-time leading scorer, passed Morton Anderson last year.
Yeah, he turned 46 in December of 2018. He really can't see it in his leg. Maybe in the beard.
You can see it in the beard.
Maybe in the beard, that's about it. But as long as he's booting them the way he's booting them, keep going, big guy.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. They trail by 10, 17-7 as they come up on a first and 10. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. The intended target was Calvin Ridley. That'll bring up second down. I hate to sound really negative, but at this point, an incomplete pass, almost a moral victory that it's not picked off.
Well, you may hate to sound negative, but that was negative.
It was very negative, I know. But all these first-half interceptions, it's been tough to watch.
Yeah, couldn't find a silver lining in this one. Much more like lead.
Hey, Wood!
Second and 10. It's Ryan again. And his throw is incomplete. He's looking for Ridley again, and it's third down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away, but the bottom line is that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. From the gun, Ryan. He's got a man complete. A big 30-yard play on third.
Obviously, they're not where they want to be right now on the scoreboard. Big plays like that, though, that'll trend them in the right direction.
Yeah, a few more like that, they'll be right back in the game. And if they can continue to do that, maybe they'll inspire their...
And now look at this. Big game, but a fumble. And the Colts pick it up. And they will take over at the 29-yard line.
We have seen this before, and we know coaches preach about this and work on it all the time. Catch the ball. You know there's going to be some traffic somewhere. They've got to put it away and secure it as they try and get downfield.
On first down, they'll start out with Matt. And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
And the hole closes quickly. He gets it across the 35 to the 36-yard line.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far, and after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much.
And for the Falcons, 5 men in the secondary, now on third. From the gun, here's Love. Into the hands of his running back, Marlon Mack. So he fought off the tackle, and that effort gives him the first before he's brought down. Move the chains, a gain of 7 on third down.
First down. First and 10 at the 43-yard line.
Shut up! 3, 9, 12.
And let's get there.
5, 5.
On first and 10, Locke.
Here we go.
And this is incomplete. Got out of the pocket. Didn't look like he had anybody open, Charles, so just gets rid of it.
And a good play by him. If no one's open and you don't have a running lane that you want to take, make the right choice. Get rid of it. Live to fight another down.
Go.
On second and 10, Locke. That is incomplete. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a 3rd and 10. Naeem Hines, his first carry. And he gets this to the 48, but no further. Well short of the line to gain. It'll be a gain of 5, and the punt team will now come out on 4th down. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
And that'll hit in the end zone. Much too much leg there. That'll be a touchback. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
But this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, had your fun? All right.
Throw it out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership. And he's taken down. Back at his own 7. Justin Houston making his presence felt there on the backfield.
Well, the pass rush has been a real strength of late. They know how to get after the quarterback.
Absolutely. 4 sacks last week. That's their first one here. Anything in particular you've seen from them or on film?
I think that they're winning athletically up front, winning those one-on-one battles. But also, when the offensive line wants to keep everyone in and mass protect, they know how to scheme their way back to the quarterback as well.
Now a shot taken on third down, but it's going to wind up incomplete.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? The zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
They've gone to the second quarter in Buffalo, and the Bengals out to the early advantage. And we'll keep you abreast of how that one shakes out. The Indy offense at the line and set to go. They're out in front. Last time they had to punt it away. We'll see if they can add to their lead now.
They don't want to go out and punt it away again. This team now.
And Luck will be intercepted for a third time. It's Desmond Trufant. And a great return as he takes this up just shy of the 45. That's sort of a second quarter to forget for him. Now two picks in this frame.
Almost as if the first one that he threw, he couldn't shake, couldn't get it out of his head. He ends up throwing a second one as a result.
Compounds the mistake a little bit.
Yeah, you got to be able to forget, compartmentalize, whatever you want to call it, and move on. He hasn't been able to do so here in the second.
And he'll be brought down somewhat awkwardly here, and a late flag as well. I think this one's going to be a face mask. A big play there on the catch and run. 37 yards. And now it's first and 10. A big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Kenny Moore. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Count them now, 6 interceptions between last week and this week. Now, the 3 picks last week helped them to a win. They're in the driver's seat once more.
And they're the ones that are doing all the leading, aren't they? Right? The 3 interceptions last week, that led to a victory. 3 interceptions so far in this game, that has them out in front. We often think of the offense driving things. In this case, it's the defense, not just holding teams, but creating big plays for themselves.
After the incompletion, here's 2nd and 10 from the 20. On 2nd down, here's a run with Mack. And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
The Colts on 3rd down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. They need just a yard here. It's 3rd and 1. Back to throw. Run. And that is incomplete. Down to 15 seconds now. The safety Keanu Neal there to knock that one free. Now here's Rigoberto Sanchez as he'll punt it away for the 2nd time. And it's taken in at the 9. And when it's said and done, it's a 58-yard punt. And control of the football, switching hands with very little time remaining until the half. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. Time here for likely one play, then off to the locker room, and they're going to have some adjustments to make.
They certainly will, and I think a lot of people are thinking to themselves, all right, take the knee, get out of here, regroup. But how will the head coach and his staff approach halftime? Will it be angry? Will it be clinical? Will they be calm? Will they just let it all out? Who knows? I'd love to be a fly on the wall for this one, though.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Colts come to the line ready to start their next drive. And both of these defenses have been stifling these last few drives offensively. Just not able to get anything going. So what needs to change?
I think a lot of the guys will go back and review, so to speak, because everyone has someone assigned to how did each play work. Okay, what did we use that kind of worked for us during this game? Try and get back some of those plays, as well as the possibility of showing something you haven't shown already in this game and trying to change things up.
We'll see if they take the advice of Mr. Davis. On 2nd down now, it's Mack. After getting stuffed on 1st down, not much better there. 2-yard gain. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
Now Locke. Throw left side complete. That's Mack. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. A gain of 11 that time, and a Colts first down.
Looked like a pretty good, safe play right there. No, he's had trouble with the interceptions in this game there. Hits his guy out in the flat.
Yeah, so many times we hear quarterbacks and offensive coordinators talk about in your progressions, you're either throwing the touchdown or you're throwing the check down. But earlier in the game, it was touchdown or interception. Now he got to the check down. A nice, safe throw and a good one.
On first down, Locke. Looking deep here for Ebron. And that'll wind up incomplete. Trying to give his man room to run under it, but it's second down.
They went with a dime look on defense. Two extra defensive backs on the field and covered up essentially every blade of grass. That allowed them to disrupt the play.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10.
X3, 218, chopper.
Big stop, D. Big stop, let's go.
Luck now to throw.
And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
And now offensively, it's third and 10, and I'm just thinking to myself, actors always say, what's my motivation before a big scene? Right now, the play caller's thinking, what have I done before that's worked well that I can go to right now?
Yeah, because they were pretty successful in the first half scoring points. Haven't done anything so far here in the second half.
45 is the mic. Woo-hoo. Hey, check mic 45. Check mic 45. 11 Z. Check 45. Hey, box drop.
Throwing on third down. Locke.
Check.
Steps away to his left. And he connects with Ebron. He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. It'll go as an impressive 31-yard gain.
First and 10 at the 21-yard line.
Ready! 55.
Here we go, deep, all day, defense.
Now it's Hines. Takes this one in for a Colts touchdown. Nyheim Hines, his first touchdown of the new season. And the Colts, they add on to their advantage.
That drive that really increased their cushion felt very military to me. Very precise, methodical, that's one of the words you've taught me. And they just got it done.
And slowly but surely now starting to pull away a little bit. Things looking good for them here in the third quarter.
Not only pulling away, but you mentioned that slowly but surely. You also drain clock, too, with a drive like that. So you really give yourself an advantage.
This one fielded at the 5. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And their halftime hole now even deeper, and they need a big drive here just to answer the first touchdown of the second half scored against them.
They were down at the half. Now, as you mentioned, they're down a little bit bigger, but no time for discouragement.
And the defense loses him. It's complete. It's a big play there for Atlanta. 46 yards.
Now look, you're not going to be able to get this all back at once, but that certainly helps.
So you're saying 3 yards in a cloud of dust, not the strategy?
I go aerial attack.
Yeah, I think that's what has to happen. And if you're going to run it, you need to break off big chunks. We just saw a big play right there. They need plenty of those.
Now a quick throw as that's complete on the hitch route.
They had the huge play last time. Here it is a much smaller gain of 2.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and you can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
And with a
flagged out. He goes down. So they're able to sack him. Now the penalty looks like it could be holding. Let's find out. And this third down looking very tough after the holding penalty. Third and long. From the gun, it's Ryan. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off down at the 10. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Charles, whatever's going on between his ears right now, it's just not completely calculated correctly. Seven picks between last week and this week after that one.
And they always say the most important part of a player is those 6 inches between the ears. But right now, it's all those interceptions that are going on. So whoever his trusted confidant is on the sidelines, I don't know if it's the offensive coordinator, quarterback's coach, maybe the backup quarterback, that's who he needs to get with now and get himself calm.
That first down completion only netted him three. Second and seven. On the delay, here's Hines. And he's got some space here. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. It's a pickup of 17 and a first down. That run in between the tackles.
Let's play the leverage game here. Offensive line just got lower than the defensive front, and they're able to get their pads on them and move them backwards and create space for their running back to roam.
Crouch. He's coming. He's coming. He's coming. We got double up.
Hey, check.
They'll run on first down with Marlon Mack, and he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
I'm coming after you. Hey, Charlie.
Now on second and 13. Luck is going to let this one go deep. And this will be caught at the 30. Touchdown, Indianapolis. T.Y. Hilton. His fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Colts, they add on to their advantage. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts, all right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
This is taken at his 4. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. They've got to dig down deep. I mean, they need something right now, really anything to cling on to. This offense has struggled.
Partner, join me in a walk to their locker room at the half, okay? Because I think what we would have seen is an offensive coordinator and his assistant coaches getting together with all their positions, then coming together as a group, going over adjustments, and then the head coach coming in and just screaming, wake up. Let's get moving, guys.
I'm kind of glad we weren't in there halftime, actually.
I mean, you think you might have turned it on us, too?
Yeah, but right now, whatever was said hasn't been working. Now the second down throw on target, and he'll be brought down shy of the 40. At the 38-yard line.
It's a gain of six. And the Falcon first down.
Try to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. So here's a first and 10 at the 38.
Come get some.
Out of the gun, it's Ryan. He'll let it go deep for Freeman. And this will be caught at the 30. A very nice pickup of 33 yards. Defensively, I know they have the comfortable lead here in the fourth, but they do not want to give up big plays like that.
They want to finish strong. So oftentimes in this situation, you tighten up underneath in your coverage and you bring your safeties back. They can pick up anything that leaks through. But in the meantime, upfield, you're making plays on the football.
Back-to-back nice gains. That one for 14 yards and another first. This is Freeman on first and 10. And they're going to get him behind the line yet again as his nightmare afternoon continues. It's a loss of a yard there and it's second down. Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11. Ryan, nowhere to escape and he goes down. The linebacker Darius Leonard applied the heat. So the sack pushes him back and now third and long for Ryan and the Falcons. Here's Ryan. This is caught, and he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. The play began back at the 23, and they pick up 23. So it's challenge time, the referee's tablet coming out, and the big question, Charles, did that football break the plane to the goal line?
They just need any part of the ball to cross the goal line in order for it to count. Remember, it's got to be indisputable, though. Sometimes we think it's going to be there. We can't really find it on the tablet. So we'll see what the final call is going to be.
And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here. And that'll bring up a second and goal. To the goal line, but it's incomplete. He was looking for Julio Jones, his Pro Bowl receiver. But now it's third and goal. This Colts D up to the challenge so far, but they need another stop here on third and goal.
Hey, Alpha!
58, right over there, Yeah. Mike, 58, right there.
From the shotgun, Ryan. And he's got his star receiver. It's Jones for the Falcon touchdown. Julio Jones. His fourth touchdown on the year. Now Ryan. And the Falcons cut into that lead. Well, it's still an uphill battle from here, that's for sure, but that makes it a two-score game.
And now we see why teams practice so much on the two-point conversion, why you have more than one play ready, because you may need multiples throughout a ball game. Here's a great example right there.
And he'll get it up across the 20 to the 21-yard line. The Indy offense at the line and set to go. Now there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation.
It got his man complete. He got 29 yards that time. They have the nice cushion. They just want to pour it on right now, still throwing the football.
And I know my background says, why do you need to do this? Just go ahead and run out the clock and get a win. But as many people pointed out to me, this is a video game, man. Go ahead and put the numbers up. Sportsmanship, not an issue.
Exercise those fingers. And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10.
12. Get off the field. Hey, orbit.
From the 50, it's long. Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Mack. And that's going to be good for another first down as the tackle's made at the Falcons' 36. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
And he'll be brought down on the 30-yard line after a gain of six.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion. They would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
Check out! Blue 40! Hey, check.
Block on third down. Lush coming, and he's taken down. That's their first time getting to the quarterback, sack number one. And, you know, they had five last week, I'm remembering.
And you have to find a way to slow down the pass rush, not necessarily with just protecting your quarterback, but you show them a lot of different looks, and they did that in the first half. You know, different angles, different things to slow down the speed. They got to him here in the second half. Now they've got to come up with a counter to that and maybe do something different.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
It takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. To throw again, Ryan. And he comes back with one complete. The reception good for seven. It's third down. You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give him that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle him after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
Escaping the pressure right. And now here is another interception. Quincy Wilson with the INT. And they take possession of the football and have it at the 36-yard line. Good starting field position for the Colts as they have it first and 10.
General West.
And they'll start on the ground with Hines. And a 6-yard gain gets them right around the 43. Good gain there on first down. It keeps them in a running situation, probably.
They did everything right on that play, didn't they? They got the leverage up front. Good blocking. Nice hole for him. Ends up picking up nice yardage. Stays in bounds to keep the clock rolling. They're in charge of this scenario right now. They want to stay that way.
They're not in any rush offensively. Just a gain of a yard there, and now it'll be third down.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
On third down, Hines. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short. So this one winds up an Indianapolis victory, and they were really helped by their defense, forcing three turnovers.
I think what we saw in this one, today's defense. And what I mean by that is in the old days, pitching shutouts was big time. That was paramount. But the big thing was holding people down, holding down their yardage, right? Don't let them throw the ball through the air and gain a lot of... But now, it's about taking the ball away. Taking away possessions, getting the ball back for their offense. They had three takeaways in this one, and it led them to victory.
So for Indianapolis, it's an ideal start as they move to 3-0 now on the young season. And they'll get another home date next week as the Raiders will come to town. Meanwhile, for the Falcons, they suffered defeat for the first time as they dropped to 2-1. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves at home next week. Thanks for tuning in, everybody. Alongside Charles Davis, we thank our entire crew. I'm Brandon Gauden. This is the NFL on EA Sports.